So this is my first ever voiceover. So I wanted to do these to tell y'all about my thought process of making my little latte arts and what I'm trying to achieve. So here I'm first swirling the espresso with the syrup because mocha tends to be really thick and sits at the bottom. And now I'm taking my milk, tapping it on the counter so I can get rid of the bubbles, swirling it around. Now I'm incorporating it into the espresso and the mocha. And now I'm trying to have the foam just sit right on top of the espresso and then swirling it, or should I say squiggling it, then pulling through to make that beautiful design. And here I accidentally made too big of a butt. So next time I'll try to do better. So here I'm making a cappuccino, specifically a salted caramel cappuccino, one of my personal favorites. And so again, I'm tapping the milk, getting it smooth without bubbles, incorporating the milk into the espresso and the syrup. So here I didn't really like how some of the milk is still shown on top, so I mix it all together to make a really nice smooth base. And here I try to again have the foam just sit right on top and pull through. And I made a teeny little heart here, it's so cute. But I'm really nitpicky about my tail. You see my little tail's like whoop to the side. So hopefully next time I can like pick up my pitcher more faster to not have it swoop to the side like that. Here we are making a honey lavender latte. And with this one, with this specific latte, I'm actually using almond milk. Almond milk is one of the more harder milks to steam. It is more thinner, and it actually, whenever it's steamed, it makes a lot of bubbles, as you can see here. So I'm incorporating the milk. It's very bubbly, and it's really hard to make latte art as well. So here I'm attempting to make some sort of heart. Kind of fail. Not kind of. I failed. And actually, I spilled a little bit on myself. Thank goodness I had a backup plate there, so I sit on the plate, bring the other plate to the side, and I just clean up a little bit. Just clean up my little mess right there, little whoop, little sweep. And then a cool trick I've been taught is I take a little stopper and just pull it through and continue to make the little heart design. So I'm gonna freeze frame right here in 3, 2, 1, freeze frame so you can see. So here I'm making a latte, and this is made with whole milk, and whole milk is actually one of the easiest milks to not only steam but also to work with. So what I do here is I actually pour a little bit out to get the initial bubbles, and incorporating the milk into the espresso once again. Had a good base here, and I'm trying to again just let the foam just sit right on top. I had a rough start, but here I am squiggling and pulling through. Ooh, kind of cute. I made like a little feather. Adorable. I have to like carefully set it down on the plate and then serve. And this last drink of the day, this is a regular. He always comes in and orders a cappuccino just as is and with whole milk, so I love hearing that. Swirling it around again, swirling the espresso around to get rid of some of the bubbles as much as I can. I'm really struggling to swirl this around. You see multiple times I'm trying to swirl and get rid of the bubbles. And again, tapping the milk, incorporating the milk into the espresso. And here I'm trying to be, I'm going crazy now. Going multiple layers. Here we go. Bloop. I'm trying to maintain like space in between each like circle of milk so I can have that like layered effect. And I pulled through and made that beautiful design. And I made a little mess, so I take my little rag there, just clean up a little bit on the side. Beautiful. So yeah, there you go, my little cappuccino design. And then I serve it off to the customer. So to end today's video, I wanted to share a shot of an espresso bowl. It's so hard to say the word sometimes. Espresso. So I'm actually thinking about making this into a small reel or a TikTok. And so anyways, I want to thank everybody for stopping by and taking the time to watch this little video of mine, and I can't wait to see y'all next week. Thank you for watching. Bye.